yet another vlog on Butler's Empire. Sharon's, tell them, Sharon, I like a pie, don't I?
Love a pie.
And I don't eat that processed food anymore, as you probably know. Let's show you how she makes the pastry, which is low carb, for my pie. And then I've got loads of other stuff to show you, so I'll see you in a minute. Right, what you got here, baby?
We got almond flour, chickpea flour, psyllium husk.
Psyllium husk? I've never heard of that before. Let's show them, hold on. So there's all the ingredients, as you can probably see there. I've got to stop saying that, Shell, as you can probably see. Someone had a go at me, one of the OCD people. They said to me...
Well, there's a word you say that grates on me at the moment.
I can't say it because everything's a load of old...
I know how that person feels.
It's what, the word I'm using quite a lot recently is what the cows leave in a field.
Well, the male cows.
The male cows leave in a field, yeah? And I'm using that word quite a lot recently.
A lot.
Anyway, that's another story. So, those are all the ingredients. You've got all the measurements down there as well, which is handy. And all that is now in there. And this is going to form the pastry to my pie. You made a couple of pies out of this, didn't you?
Yeah.
Right, she's just stored the meat for my oven, the meat for my pie, in here. This is what's going in the pie. I don't know if you can see that or not. Let's show you. So this is the content. This is meat-free, what's it called, Shell?
Hang on.
Oh, she's got the cover. She's got the meat, she's got the box there. This is the meat-free mince that I use. And as you can see, sugar's there. 0.1, which is less than 1% grams. Per whatever it is, per 100 grams. So that's virtually none in there. She's got onion in there. Onion's technically, there's a bit of sugar in an onion, but nothing for me to worry about. You've got mushrooms in there. You've also got, these things are chickpeas, aren't they, Shell?
Yeah.
You've got gravy, Sharon, in there, have you?
Maggie's seasoning and gravy.
Maggie's seasoning, which is this stuff here. It's a liquid seasoning. And all you do is like just sprinkle it in like that. I'll have loads of this. I could put loads of this on. So that's that. And then you just cook it down in the frying pan as normal. Just keep turning that over and you end up with that. And that is the filling for my pies. There's the pastry. And where's your pastry containers, baby?
What?
Where's your pastry things you put in them?
Pie containers.
Sorry, your pie containers.
I'm just gonna reach up and get them out.
Can you reach up there, baby?
Just about.
Look at that. And how many did you get out of this?
Well, two with that pastry. I hopefully might get three.
You get normally three because the last one you done, if you remember rightly...
It was the pastry I run low on.
You run low of pastry, but you had one of these ramekins full of mince and I ate it cold, didn't I? So that's what I do anyway. Mm-hmm. So what are you talking about? You're going to put cauliflower. You can make...
Yeah, I said I could have. But...
Yeah, with that other one, you can make a cottage pie with...
That's what I just said.
...cauliflower on chop.
You make it up. You come up with the idea.
I know. I know, baby. All right. So Sharon's doing that anyway. And then she freezes them in them.
Got me rolls in the oven and all.
Yeah, we've got our rolls as well. And as I say, this is just what we're doing. Everything's made fresh, so to speak. But that's what makes me like a pie again. That and also this pastry, which Sharon now found a recipe for, which I've just shown you.
No, we didn't find the recipe. You made that recipe up.
Well, I pinched half of it off of someone else, basically.
Did you?
Yeah, it ain't fully my idea, I don't think. You can call it Martin's pastry if you want, yeah?
I thought it was your idea.
Well, it was. Nothing's original, baby. Everything's an adaption. Even songs. When people write a song, they've taken the inspiration from someone else.
Really?
Yes. Anyway, I want to show them outside, Shell. I've got a few things to show them, but there's one thing we've got to do today, Shell, is say happy birthday to somebody. Now, we don't normally do requests, but we're going to do it on this case because it's a special birthday for one of our viewers, Shell, who loves our videos. And it's Mark, and this was sent in by Adam, I think it's his son.
Yeah.
Mark will be 60 on the 30th of May, very soon. And he ever guess what he calls his wife, Carol? Babe.
Actually, better than babe.
You're baby. But sometimes I call you babe.
Call me a lot of things.
I call you a lot of things some other time. So Mark, happy birthday. I'm glad you enjoyed.
Happy birthday.
I'm glad you enjoyed the videos and liked the channel as well. And also say hello to Carol. Hi, Carol.
Hello, Carol.
And thank you very much indeed. I won't sing happy birthday because she can't sing to save her life. Yeah?
Not lying.
And as I say, thank you, Adam, for sending in that little email. And Mark's actually restored, I don't know how long ago it was, a Triumph Vitesse. I love them Triumph Vitesse. It's six-cylinder, straight six-cylinder if I remember rightly, Mark. And I don't know whether you took the body off of the chassis, because I know they do separate and come apart in three parts. Or is it two parts? Come apart in two parts,
I think. I'd say two.
But lovely car, very quick motors if I remember rightly. I've been in one once, many, many years ago as a teenager, and very, very fast to the acceleration when you put your foot down. Woof, pulls you back like that, Sharon.
How'd it go?
Eh?
How'd it go?
Oof.
No, the first time it went woof.
Yeah, well, I didn't go so fast the second time, did I? Right, anyway, happy birthday, Mark.
Yeah,
and
happy birthday.
Glad you enjoyed the videos. Hope you're watching all the channels as well. And if you get Adam to send me your, what's it called?
Address.
Address. I'll stick a couple of my stickers in the post for you.
Oh my
so
God.
You can put
your
them up.
Your life's complete. You're getting his stickers. What
that'll
more
be from myself
want?
And Sharon anyway. And we've
Sharon will stick a pen in. There
a pen? They'll crack them pens, shall we? Can't get on with them. Can't send him one.
Actually, I've got one in my handbag.
Shall
that's perfectly.
We'll send him a fridge magnet. We've got a few left.
I'll still send
very
him
limited
then.
Amount. We'll send you a fridge magnet, mate. Anyway, thanks very much. That's that.
Happy birthday.
Talking about cars, shall oh, here's the pilot. Let me just quickly show you how she does this pie before we go outside. So she rolled it out a little bit. It's a little, she rolled
it's
out.
Very sticky.
Yeah, it's a sticky pastry. She rolled it out between two pieces of, one piece of, what's it called? Greaseproof paper, yeah. Folded it over, rolled it out. But it does tend to stick to everything.
Gets on my nerves.
So you end up putting it in the pastry case like this and just
thumb. Of course, I'll have to roll the lid out.
You thumb it up, Shell, don't you?
Pardon me.
So that's what she ends up doing with that. Can you just make one pie up first, Shell? Oh, it's not hard, Shell, is it? It's not rocket science, is it?
I think your viewers.
Hey?
The ages that they all are.
Shell, I want them to see the sort of.
None of them are babies, and they all know what a pie is.
No,
looks
yeah,
like.
But Shell, they don't know this pie don't contain virtually any carbohydrates.
Don't contain much.
So all she'll do, she'll get the spoon, she'll get the mixture, and I like a full pie, Shell. I like a full one, baby, don't I?
What are you telling me
for? Hey?
That?
Well, you know I like a full
exactly.
pie.
So why don't tell me? Please?
I do hate to bite into a pie and there's nothing inside
it. And he likes
it.
Pastry on the top and on the bottom.
Yeah, it's got to have a bottom to it, the pastry. Look at her whack all that in there, look.
Squeeze it, dear.
Get it all in there. And then she'll take another bit of pastry. You will get three out of that, shall I? Look at that.
Yeah, it's the pastry. That's my problem.
All right, baby. Well, we know what we're doing with the third one now then, don't we, as I said to you. Right, so now what are you going to do?
Well, I've got to try and roll something
out. Oh, isn't it hard? Yeah, go on and try to do a little bit while we're here. So you can even, I don't think you'll get it flat enough just pressing it. Roll it out, baby. Roll it out.
See, look, it sticks. It winds.
Yeah, well, chow, don't get wound up, baby. Don't get wound up.
When you do cooking that I do, this isn't right.
Call it therapy, chow.
Don't.
Come on. Here, so peel it back, baby.
See, then
now what do you do?
Try.
Yeah, okay, go on. Off. Yeah, go on. You'll be all right. Peel it away, baby.
I'm trying to.
Go on, you're nearly there. That's lovely. Now lay it on.
Oh,
look at that. And them little gaps she's got, look, just thumb it round and bring it together, and that's my little pie. Well, I say little pie, shall I? It's absolutely enormous. And that's just how I like it. Now that I will have on a plate with masses of, what's it called? Cabbage? Cauliflower,
just,
broccoli.
Why don't you say vegetables?
Well, I like to let them know, Shell, because we don't. Vegetables covers carrots and stuff like that. Root vegetables. No root vegetables. Carrots, broccoli, all the leafy things I have. And then I'll cover it with gravy as well. A massive plateful.
You have a Yorkshire pudding, but I make my Yorkshire puddings.
Yeah. Go on, tell us, Shell.
32 grams of arrowroot, 120 grams of cream. I found single cream gives the lighter tasting. What are they called? Yorkshire's.
Batter.
Yorkshire's.
Batter.
Yeah, and two eggs.
Two eggs.
That's it. And my God, they give me the best Yorkshire puddings
I've
ever
done. Can I just say something? Do you put baking powder in there?
No, I've just told
you. Oh,
don't you? I've just told you what I put in there.
All right, baby, I'm just asking, because it's easy to forget stuff, baby, isn't it?
And they rise. Well, I've never had Yorkshire puddings rise like it.
Yeah.
You wouldn't know they weren't.
They rise like a Premiership. No, they rise like a. I don't know what they rise like, shall
I? I could say savage.
Go on.
No.
They rise like what?
No, I'm not saying. You know what I'm thinking, ladies.
Shannon, might not be any ladies watching, baby.
Barbara.
Barbara.
Carol.
Barbara Cowell's watching, yeah, definitely.
There we go.
All right, we won't mention what her eyes are showing anyway.
There's more ladies than that that watch.
Yeah, anyway, so that's how we do it. I'm going outside now, Shout. I've had enough of this. I've had my lunch anyway, that's another story. And let's go outside and have a look at the Triumph Acclaim, what I've done, what I've got to do, and take it from there. And then we go out to the log cabin. I want to show you a couple of little bits out there as well. Bye, baby. Here we go, back out the front. As you probably know, if you watch Retro Restore, the engine's running. Everything's back to normal. I've got a new battery on it now. We've got the, that's the side of the brakes that I've done. So I've turned the car around under its own steam, although I haven't bred the brakes yet. Bled the brakes rather. I've got to now just check out these wheels. I'm gonna refurb the front like I did on the other side. I don't need to take the drive shafts off though, because there's no gator problems on this one. But this will have the caliper taken apart, powder coated, just like the other one. And I've got all that to come. But yeah, so I'm very near the stage now of getting this thing cut back, the paintwork, because I don't want to start bolting things like bumpers on and then start to cut the paintwork back. So I might be starting that very, very shortly. Give it a good wash down, give it a good clean up, because as you can see, it's covered in this blinking dust and dirt and whatever. And as I say, although this has got 3 coats of lacquer on, as I've mentioned before, it's covered in cobwebs and stuff. So that's something I'm going to start work on. And the interior needs to be cleaned out, although there's not much to do in here, to be honest with you. It does smell very old. I may get one of those, what they call them, air freshener bombs or whatever, and try and put that in there. But it smells old. The seats probably need a good clean. And coming into the back as well, as you can see, everything's in blinking good nick there, as you can see. Look, absolutely lovely. So I'm looking forward to getting this ready now. And there's a few little things to sort out in here. I've got a lens here, but I've got one of them which is broken there, so I'm gonna have to fix that. I'll show you that in a minute. I'm gonna try that with that ultraviolet light gun that I've got. I haven't found one of these on eBay, to be honest with you. I've had a little look. There are some of these on there, this type, but it's not that type I need. I've got one of these which is broken, so we need to look for one of them. I've got that to paint, the cap for the fuel cap, which is sitting in the back there, as you can probably see. And also the boot lid's got to be taken off and also painted as well. The wheels have still, 3 of the wheels have still got to be taken off and painted. So, and put new tyres put on them, although that one looks okay, but I will have a matching set on there, I think. I'll get them wheels sorted out one at a time. And they're not the best tyres which I'll be putting on there, they're only cheapo ones, but it will do for now. And little things I need to sort out. Let me just take the bonnet off for a minute, hold on, bear with me. Put that over there. Things that I need to sort out in here, for example, this did have a little plate welded on there, obviously before I had it, but they didn't paint it properly, and it's got a bit of surface rust on there, so I'll wire brush that down. And he's put some, what's that called, tiger seal around the actual little plate he put on there when he done that. But if I'm taking that suspension strut out, I may be able to just tidy that up a little bit better and get to the other side of it and seal it all up properly. So that's got to be looked at. And underneath the brand new battery there, the battery tray's got a bit of corrosion on it. It does bolt in, that battery tray, so I will take that out as well. Or what I want to do to tune the carburetors up, I've had the carbs off before to have them clean, so I know they're clean. So I need to remember or find where the mixture screws are on them. And I also possibly am going to get a colour tune. Remember the old colour tune where you used to take a spark plug out, screw a see-through adapter in, and it tells you what mixture you're burning by the colour of the actual flame that it shows? And I was going to tune the carburetors using the colour tune. So I'll keep my eyes out for a colour tune there. It's had a temporary washer bottle motor put in it there, as you can see. I don't know what this is for. This is the only thing that I haven't looked into yet. This power for the, I don't know whether this is washer bottle or what, I'm not sure. But that's something that's got to be looked into. The heater over there, that's the 3-port valve down there for the heater. And last time that was stuck on, but when I warmed it up yesterday, up to temperature, it was actually fine. So there's a very good chance that that's probably still free now and loose, so I'm happy with that as well. The fan cut in when it warmed up, so that was all right, so I know that's fine. So all in all, things are really progressing now, and I'm actually getting somewhere. I'll be doing stuff on here, obviously, like the brakes. I probably won't be showing you that on, there's no need to do another video on that because I've already done this side, so you won't see that. You might see me do little bits on Butler's Empire channel and stuff like that, but not as a Triumph video. So yeah, getting there now. I'm getting really pleased now because it's getting near driving it for real. and I'll get it taxed and insured and MOT'd and all that, and hopefully get this little beauty going again. Let's go out the back. Right, here we are, back in the workshop again, and I bought some of these rods. I got these off of Facebook now, and they showed you, you might see, if you've been on Facebook, they flash up an advert every now and again, and I've had some of these before, but not this type, where you can braze or weld, whatever you want to call it, or solder these rods and join various things together. And I bought a load of these, and they come folded in half. Just literally, you can see they've been opened up there. They was bent in half like that, bent in half like that, just stuck in an envelope. £30 I paid for them. There's 10 sticks of solder in each, but yeah, £30 I had to pay for them. I'm disgusted with the way they were sent. But anyway, Facebook, I'm not on Facebook anymore. I've pulled off of Facebook, by the way, folks. Those of you who do send me any messages or whatever via Facebook, I've come off of Facebook. I'm just fed up with all the crap that's on there at the moment, and I only used to go on there to share my videos anyway, and perhaps look at other stuff, and people used to send me messages on there. But if anyone wants to send me a message now, send it to my email, which is retrorestoreuk@gmail.com. That's the way to contact me now. If you're putting anything on Facebook, I'm not even looking on Facebook at the moment, so that's how to contact me if you want to do so on a one-to-one basis. Anyway, so that's that. What else have I got to show you? I'll be back on Sharon's lawnmower very, very soon. Again, I've had the car. We've had other things we've got to deal with as well. So we'll be back on that. So I located one of these broken lenses I had on the Triumph Acclaim, and I can't find these on eBay. I can find the red ones, as I said earlier on. But this one, as you can see, it's got a clean break there, and it goes together absolutely perfectly, as you can see, look. So I was going to glue it with super glue to see if that would hold it, but I thought I might try that clear bond that activates with a UV light. I've got some up here, look, that I had on my wish list that one of my subscribers sent me, and it's called Bondic. So let's have a little go with this. And all you basically do with this, it comes in a little tube at one end, and the other end is the UV light to cure it. So you're supposed to put the fluid up. In fact, let's do it. Let's just do it. Let's not talk about it. Let's do it. So all we're going to do is remove the cap to it and sprinkle it, or not sprinkle it, I mean, make sure it goes on the surfaces, spread it about all the way around where the broken line is. Right, that's that. So I've only put it on one side. See, nothing will happen until I activate the UV light on it, apparently. So we need to hold it together, which it should go straight together. Keep it flat and then shine this UV light on it. It's supposed to be 4 to 8 seconds in each area. I'm going to give it a bit more time, obviously. And what I'll even do is just turn it around and do the back end as well. And this UV light is supposed to cure it and set it hard within sort of no time, basically. So I'm hoping it's going to do the job. We'll soon know in a second. There we go. So I'm rubbing my finger, you can see it raised there. Can you see a little bit raised there? That's actually rock hard. That appears to have done it. I'm not going to force it, obviously, but if that saves me buying a new one, which are very hard to come by, then that's going to be okay. That's formed a rock solid. I can't even dig my nail into it. How about that? There we go. I've just repaired it. With this stuff, this is quite dear though, as I said to you. I think this was $19.99 for that little amount. And it comes in this box, and it's called Bondic, and it's cured by UV light, whatever that liquid is. Apparently they use it in the, it was originated from the dental profession. You know, like when you go to the dentist and people are having false teeth put in, and they put the a big clamp in their mouth to open their mouth up, and then they shine a UV light in there. Apparently that's where the technology come from. But that's perfect, that's done the job. I'm happy with that. And what else I've got to do is just, it come out of this one. This one's obviously been bashed before. It's quite dented, so I'm going to have to straighten that one out. But it will go back in there. I think it come out of there like that. So that's where it comes from. So I've got another one of these. So I will straighten this one up. This has got a metal insert, you see. And these cost about £30 if you find these on eBay, £25 to £30. So I should be able to straighten this up. Let's go and have a look if we can do that. Right, so I've got the old ones there. Or the good ones, should I say. And if I lay them both on the flat on the counter, as you can see, the good one, it's a lot different than the bad one. So I'm hoping that if I just put that on a flat surface, maybe I can just dress that back into place so that it ends up like that one. And as I say, this doesn't really need replacing if I can straighten it out. Okay, so I'm going to give that a go now with some tapping and ticking and see if I can get that straight. I think it's okay. Turn it around that way. That's what it looks like now compared to what it used to look like. I don't think there's much difference there at all now. The one I've got my hand on is the bent one, and that's the straight one. So I think I just saved myself a few pounds there.
Yeah, I'm happy with that.
That's it. Nice simple repair done. Happy days. Just need a good clean up and I'll paint them with the Pledge Revive It, and that should bring them back to a nice shine as well. So that's that done. I'm pleased with that. I'm so happy working in the workshop now. Now it's nice, clean and tidy. So I've been, you know, it gets a bit frustrating when you don't know where you've put something or you've misplaced something or whatever. And then you've got sons who come around, borrow stuff and don't tell you they've borrowed it. And someone did mention, slightly off subject, I've just looked over there and I've seen that pillar drill about the size of the chuck. Someone said measure the hole. So let's go and have a look at that quickly. So I was told by a few people, let's move that off of there for the minute, that it should have whatever the size is written around it. So I don't know. Let me get my magnifying glass out first of all. As I say, I don't know what size this is. I'll read out what's there and then you tell me what you think it is. It's got 1-16. Does that mean 1 mil to 16 mil? I don't know. And it's got 1/32-3/8. What's the number there? J6S3. Whatever that means, Germany. It's got written Germany on that side. But that's all the writing that's on there. And someone said measure the size of this hole here, which if I open that up, that's 10 mil. So that hole, for the centre spline of the chuck key, it looks like to me 10 mil, yeah. So there you go. Maybe you can point me to the right size chuck key, what I need for that, with that information. And if you do find one on eBay or something, just leave a link in the description in the comment section and I'll be able to obviously order it on the strength of what you said, because I don't know what size it is. I've tried ordering one, as I showed you before. I bought this blinking thing and that's a load of rubbish, no good whatsoever. Anyway, thank you very much for your help on that one. If you can do that for me, I'll be most grateful. Right, let's put that back up there. It looks like this has turned into a tinkering about video, which I know you like, or quite a few of you do like. And one thing I've got to do is to start work on these front and rear bumpers. They're covered in grease and dirt at the moment, so I'll just give them a squirt of WD-40 and a rag. Where are we? Use one of my old vests. And I'll just give that a wipe over. Now, as I say, these are in pretty good condition anyway, so they're just going to need a surface sand down. And a prime, well, yeah, probably a prime, or maybe just some of this tough black paints that you can buy. I think Simon Eyes do a good one. They do it in satin. I want these to be a satin finish. And I'll probably just end up just painting them with a tough black paint. I think they need a little bit of work in places, but maybe a sand will get rid of the stuff which is on them. I'm not sure yet, so we'll just give them a wipe down first. I've just noticed that there's a couple of bolts that have been stuck in the ends of the bumpers where they are attached to the plastic cover, so I'll have to get them out as well. But all I'm going to do here, let me show you, I'm just wiping that down like that. I've got Jimmy's DA. This is his one. I still haven't found mine. I don't know where it is, and that's a blinking point, isn't it? I've been through the whole workshop and I haven't found it, so he must have borrowed it. And he did find this the other day. Where is it? What did he find? Oh, my. Look, you may remember I kept on about my Dremel was missing, and I've asked him and he said, yeah, he looked in his van. Well, just before he cleaned his van out, before he sold it, he said, Mum, look what I found. And it was my Dremel, even though he told me that he'd searched his van and it was under all the crap and rubbish that he had in there. So yes, he did have it. And I still think he might have had my sander somewhere. I don't know. Anyway, let's put some, what's he got on there? He's got some paper on there already. Has he got 80 grit on there, has he? Or? Yeah, he's got a bit of old 80 grit. I might just use that just to go over it and just see what we end up with. No, I'm going to change it for 120. Be back in a minute. Hold on. Right, I'll give this a quick go with some 180. He's on there. That's it. Right, yeah, put a bit of 180 on there. Right, so that's that. I'll keep that anyway. So all I'm going to do is give it a sand down with the 180. Oh, hold on. Missus has come back. Look. Hello.
I'm
going to
take Barney for a walk with the
Come here. You're in my domain now, not the kitchen, you're in my domain. Where are you going?
Walk.
You're going for a walk. Well, I'm going to carry on doing this. I've got stuff to do. Barney's in it. Oh, sorry. Just don't do nothing, baby. You haven't done that. I've done it.
Daddy done it.
You watch. He hates us cuddling. Come here. Come on, look. Come on. Come on, baby.
He just wants to.
You watch. Come on, Leo, jump up in a minute.
He's not going to do it.
Oh, no, he's not going to do it. He can't hear us. Look, he's deaf as a pope. Look, come on, oh, baby. Come on, baby. Yeah, come on. Yeah, there we go. He's up. Look, he's up.
Oh, his claws in your back.
And he scratches our back when he does it. So when you see scratch marks on my back, it's not her, it's him. Hey, go on in, off you go, Sha. Or should I? Hey, come here.
I'll lock you in.
Oh, let's go anyway, because. I could do this another day, Sha. Shall I come for a walk with you?
Yeah.
Hey, do you want me to come with you? Yeah. Oh, we're going to go for a walk, get a bit of exercise. We've already walked down the road anyway.
We've done 4,000 steps.
Have we?
Hang on.
We like to do 10,000 or so a day. Although she watches it, I don't really watch it.
4,275.
Yeah. So I was going to show you. Well, in fact, look, Sha. In fact, come here. Let's get her doing a little bit. Right.
I've got a lot of vibrations.
Sha, hey? You don't like the vibrations? Come and hold this.
No.
Come and hold it.
Why?
Trust me, I'm a doctor.
It's not a woman's job.
Shall?
Oh, sorry for you women that do.
Trust me, I'm not going to hurt you. Right. Now. Listen, if you press that thing, what?
No.
Come here.
Yeah.
Come nearer. You've walked away from me, baby.
Like it.
Hold on to it like that. And you see your palm of your hand? That pushes down on that like that. Okay, so just hold it first, but don't press that down. Hold it in your palm. It's a palm sander.
I don't want to do it. Don't you understand?
Right, now before you do anything, just give it a little squeeze in your hand. Go on, a bit more. That's lovely. Right, now let me just turn that over like that. Now you see that? Put it flat on the top there. Now, press that thing in again. Move it along. Keep moving sideways. There you go. Keep going. What do you think of that?
I'm bored of it. Yeah.
You're bored with it? Look what you've gone through to the bare metal, baby.
That's what you wanted, isn't it?
Hey?
That's what you wanted. See, fancy letting me do something I don't know what I'm doing.
You know, baby.
It's not like a sewing machine, is it? I'm getting a bit more knowledgeable with that.
What was that?
So it's not like a sewing machine. I'm getting to know a bit about them.
Well, you're getting to know a bit about my domain and my world, Sharon.
Oh, perhaps you'll have to go with me sewing machine.
I can do sewing machine,
no
problem.
Touching,
anyway, thanks for watching, folks. It's just a little tinkering about vlog, baby. And hope you've enjoyed it. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button. If not, share our videos out on Facebook. I've told her I've come off Facebook, baby, haven't we?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's too much rubbish on there. So, as I said...
Apart from my family, they're not rubbish.
Yeah, well, but provided everyone knows our email shout. Anyone who wants to talks to us via blinking email, don't they?
Yeah, they ring me.
Or they phone us if they got our phone number.
But I'm going to go because I'm already late.
Yes, and I'm coming with you. We'll see you later, folks. Don't forget, hit the subscribe button, ring that little notification bell and set your preferences to all. And that way, you'll get notified next time we, her, me, us, upload a video. Thanks, folks. We'll see you later. Bye for now. Let's go, baby. Turn everything off, Cher.
What am I going to do?
Go on, off you go.